the way to learn Chinese. Chinese pot, Chinese pot, Chinese pot. That's the way to learn Chinese.
Hello there, Allies. This is Chinese Pot and I'm Ken Carroll.
Hello, I'm Jenny.
Now we're at a hotel.
Yes.
Tell us something about the hotel.
Ooh, we want to put our luggage
yes.
in the concierge.
In the concierge, behind the desk somewhere. Mm. You want to store the luggage in the hotel. Now, a couple of things. First of all, this is common in China if you're traveling, because usually, you know, you don't travel by car here so much.
Yes.
If you're in the States, you probably don't use the car or whatever. But here, quite often, we don't hire cars even when we go to different cities.
Not really.
We just take taxis. Mm. So asking to leave your luggage is quite common.
Yes.
Right? Yeah. And second, what type of hotel do you think we're at here? Are we talking like the Hyatt Regency? No, I don't think so.
Oh, you're so elitist, Ken.
I'm saying we're not.
We're not. That's the point. Well, we know we're not in a very posh hotel because
the staff is
very nonchalant.
It's a bit nonchalant, not rude or anything, but kind of nonchalant, yeah.
Withdrawn.
So I think we're in a 3-star hotel here.
Mm.
And we have something to say about that because those are interesting institutions in their own right. Let's listen to the dialogue 3 times and then we'll come back and we'll have a look at it.
对话第一遍。
这么多行李真麻烦。
那我们放在服务台吧。你好，我的行李可以放在这里吗？
可以，请问您什么时候来拿？
2个小时以后。
好的，请签名。
谢谢。
哎呦，这么多。
第二遍。
这么多行李真麻烦。
那我们放在服务台吧。你好，我的行李可以放在这里吗？
可以，请问您什么时候来拿？
2个小时以后。
好的，请签名。
谢谢。
哎呦，这么多。
第三遍。
这么多行李真麻烦。
那我们放在服务台吧。你好，我的行李可以放在这里吗？
可以，请问您什么时候来拿？
2个小时以后。
好的，请签名。
谢谢。
哎呦，这么多。
Okay, let's translate it.
这么多行李，真麻烦。
So much luggage. This is a real hassle.
这么多行李，真麻烦。
So much luggage. What a hassle.
这么多行李，真麻烦。那我们放在服务台吧。
Well, let's leave it at the service desk.
那我们放在服务台吧。
Well, let's leave it over at the service desk.
那我们放在服务台吧。你好，我的行李可以放在这里吗？
Hi, can I put my luggage here?
你好，我的行李可以放在这里吗？
Hi, can I put my luggage here?
你好，我的行李可以放在这里吗？可以，请问您什么时候来拿？
Yeah, you can. Let me ask, when would you come back to pick it up?
可以，请问您什么时候来拿？
Yeah, sure. When are you going to come to pick it up?
可以，请问您什么时候来拿？2个小时以后。
In 2 hours.
2个小时以后。
After 2 hours.
2个小时以后。好的， 请签名。
Okay, please sign here.
好的，请签名。
All right, sign here, please.
好的，请签名。谢谢。
Thanks.
谢谢。
Thanks.
谢谢。哦呦，这么多。
哎呦 ，so many bags.
哦呦，这么多。
Whoa, that's a lot of baggage.
哦呦，这么多。
Huh.
Well, either they do really have a lot of baggage or the two men just, they're girly men, they're so fragile.
Or, I don't know, he's just lazy or something. He doesn't want to be bothered. But who knows? Anyway, so, but this is kind of realistic, I think. It really is. But let's look at the language first. We'll look at the cultural bit in a moment. Now, first sentence is very straightforward, but it's very rich lexically. So let's just go through it one time.
这么多行李真麻烦。这么多行李真麻烦。
Now, the word for luggage, of course, is...
行李。
So, the tones are...
Second and neutral.
Good, 行李。
对。
Now, and of course, 这么多。Now, we have a lot of this. 这么多,那么多, all of this stuff here. You'll hear it throughout here. And then the word bother is...
麻烦。麻烦。
麻烦。
对。
Now, this is very common. Really useful phrase. 很麻烦。
对, it means... Oh,Such a hassle.
Yeah, 真麻烦. You hear it all the time. Anyway, so it means bother, hassle, it's a pain. It's the equivalent of saying, oh, what a pain.
对,
真麻
烦.
Yeah, yeah. Well, then in that case, we'll leave it behind the service desk.
那我们放在服务台吧.
Yeah, now the service desk again is...
服务台.
服务台.
对.
Tones?
服务。Second and fourth.
Yeah, now, 服务 meaning service.
Service.
And the 台 meaning
desk.
Desk, as in front desk or off, you know, at a counter of sorts.
Which is the second tone.
Yeah, and there's a particle at the end which says, it turns it into a kind of suggestion, why don't we, or let's do it.
放在服务台吧。
Okay. Now, she goes over and asks him, the way she puts it is, you know, hi, my baggage can be put here? Question? That's how she puts it. Let's hear that.
你好,我的行李可以放在这里吗?
Yeah.
我的行李可以放在这里吗?
Now, great Lex is very, very Chinese syntax, right? 我的行李, like my bags, 可以, can be, is it allowed to put here?
Yeah.And that's the pattern you use for can I do something.
That's right.
Yeah. You don't put 可以 in the beginning of the sentence.
You don't put 可以 in the beginning of the sentence. So you, nice Chinese syntax. Let's hear it one more time, please, Jenny.
我的行李可以放在这里吗?我的行李可以放在这里吗?
Now, you could use that. You could change the word 行李. You could put in any noun in there. Maybe choose another sentence and just insert another word instead of 行李.
我的书可以放在这里吗?
Can I put my book here? Yeah, yeah. So you see the pattern. I love it when you get this real Chinese syntax. It's interesting because you notice that the organization of the sentence is different. And those are patterns that are really valuable because you get them down and it helps you sound more fluent. That's the way it is. Yeah, now, of course, he's like, 可以, no problem. But he wants to know when you're coming back.
请问您什么时候来拿?请问您什么时候来拿?
So that's the collocation to 来拿, to come back and take.
Yes.
Literally spoken, the two characters mean...
Come and take.
Come and take.
Oh, I like that.
It is useful. 什么时候来拿? When would you come back to
An
take?
An open
it?
Invitation.
Yeah.
来拿.
Exactly. And so this is the context you use this language. Like in English, you'd say pick them up. When are you going to pick them up? But in Chinese, you say
来拿.
来拿.
对.
Yeah. And this is really the key, I think, to learning Chinese idiomatic fluent way is using it in the right context. Okay. Now, and there's another example of precisely this in the next sentence. Easy as it sounds. Let's listen to it.
两个小时以后。两个小时以后。
Now, we'd say in English, in 2 hours, after a couple of hours, but here we say
两个小时以后。
Meaning 2 hours
later.
That's right. 以后, yeah, 两个小时以后。And of course, it could be 4 hours later, 2 days later, 2 years later, whatever. The pattern is the same. Now, he asks her to sign, and the verb to sign, give your signature is
签名。签名，
签名，
对
，first and second is it?
You're correct.
啊，签名。Tell us a little bit about 签名.
Well, 签 means to sign, all right.
Okay.
And 名 means name.
Your name. So literally, it means...
Sign your name.
Sign name, there you go. 签名. Or if you're asking for somebody's autograph, you'd say...
签名。
签名或签个名。
对。
Yeah.
Oh, you must get that a lot, Ken.
No.
凯恩。帮我签个名。
No. Jenny Drew, a lot of people are asking you to 签名。
Oh, 没有没有。We don't need to try to flatter each other and、
okay.
ending disappointment.
Well, I don't want you to feel disappointed, so could you 签名 for me, Jenny?
We will 签名 for each other,
okay,
sure.
That's good. 签名, to give an autograph or to sign your name. Yeah, to give a signature. All right, and of course, the 哎呦.
Ayoh. Expresses surprise.
It does. It suppresses.
Sometimes like a whining surprise.
A whiny surprise. I like that. Ayoh. Actually, ayoh can be said in a million different ways.
Yeah.
Right? You know, if you're ayoh, it will be a surprise, but not whiny. Whiny surprise will be.
Ayoh. Ayoh. Grumpy surprise, right?
Yeah. How about a kind surprise? Ayoh.
Yeah. A delightful
surprise.
Surprise.
So there's many ways to use ayo.
Ayo.
It's very, very... We could do an entire lesson based on the sound ayo.
对.
Or you catch your finger and say, ah, ayo. Right?
Wow.
There's endless ways to use ayo.
We might have just uncovered the most versatile word in Chinese.
I think we might have done, but it would be very interesting, I think, to guess what we could do. Maybe do some ayos and have people guess from context what they mean. Let's look at that, maybe. All right. So, 这么多, we have that pattern again. So the guy's not pleased. Now, we're going to talk about the type of hotel this might be in a moment. Let's listen to it one more time so we make sure we get the meaning first.
How?
Welcome back to another installment of Chinese Pod Trivia. And the question for you is, for what test does Chinese Pod offer preparation services for? Is it A, the polygraph, B, the colonoscopy, C, the HSK test, or D, the CAT scan?
The CAT scan?
Ooh, sorry, that is incorrect. The correct answer is C, the HSK test. That's right, Chinese Pod will thoroughly prepare you to pass this rigorous test of proficiency in Chinese. ChinesePod.com/HSK.
Dialogue 1.
你好，我的行李可以放在这里吗？
可以，请问您什么时候来拿？
两个小时以后。
好的，请签名。
谢谢。
哎呦，这么多。
第二遍。
这么多行李，真麻烦。
那我们放在服务台吧。你好，我的行李可以放在这里吗？
可以，请问您什么时候来拿？
两个小时以后。
好的，请签名。
谢谢。
哎呦，这么多。
第三遍。
这么多行李，真麻烦。
那我们放在服务台吧。你好，我的行李可以放在这里吗？
可以。请问您什么时候来拿？
两个小时以后。
好的，请签名。
谢谢。
哎呦，这么多。
My view is, see, I've done a fair bit of traveling around China.
What is your take?
My take is that this is a 3-star hotel in a smaller second, third tier city. right?
Yeah, so by the tone and manner of the staff,
that
gives a clue.
It's not like 5-star service. You can just tell the guy's like, sure.
Not terribly helpful.
Well, he's kind of okay. He's like,
just
sure.
Just doing his job, I guess. Yeah.
And he's like, an awful lot of luggage there. I don't think people in 5-star hotels will say that. But the interesting thing is that there were thousands and thousands and thousands of hotels built here in the 80s and the 90s, right? Mm. And I've traveled to all sorts of cities. And it's funny, these 3-star hotels, they kind of all look the same.
So you keep having deja vu.
Absolutely.
Have I been here before?
Absolutely.
Not really, but in another city, maybe.
It's true. I mean, and if you do, because we did tours and stuff like that, and some days you'd wake up and you have, where am I? The hotel looks like the hotel yesterday. So there was, and there's always some gold. They try to use gold, but it's plastic and red.
Or carvings of a dragon.
Oh, dragons are everywhere, definitely. Mm. Made out of sort of that goldy plastic thing. but the interesting, that was in the 80s and the 90s, but there are some much more interesting hotels being designed now.
I think, overall, people have got a lot more savvy in terms of taste.
Yeah, for sure.
And design. Yeah. So now hotels and architecture in general, they're more diverse.
Absolutely. Mm. I think in the past, the sort of compulsion was to be the same, actually.
Yeah.
To more or less be the same. Mm. And now it's to differentiate. So you get there. And there are interesting hotels.
Boutique hotels.
Well, there's one very near my house. I won't go into the name of it, but it's so differentiated. And I was complaining about them, a lot of these hotels or something. It's actually quite weird. It's quite an experience, but I'll tell you about that in another lesson. The design is totally strange. Anyway, that was hotels. That was luggage. This was Chinese Pod. Go there, spend time, and explore the patterns. And while you're doing that, we'll be working on the next lesson.
Yes. So we will see you tomorrow. Keep studying. Keep listening. 再见.
As usual, ChinesePod provides an extensive selection of learning materials for this lesson on its website, www.chinesepod.com. You can access this lesson directly with the lesson number 1033. So just go to www.chinesepod.com/1033 and you will find a transcript, vocabulary, and much more. The link again, www.chinesepod.com/1033.